I'm Jeline and I will be discussing the sulfur cycle. But before that, let us first define sulfur. Sulfur is one of the most abundant and ubiquitous elements in living things. At room temperature, it is a yellow crystalline solid. Even though it is insoluble in water, it is one of the most versatile elements at forming compounds. Let us now go with the sulfur cycle. Sulfur cycle is the collection of processes by which sulfur moves to and from minerals in living systems. We have four stages to show how the cycle works. Stage 1 is the volcanic eruption. Volcanic eruption is one way for sulfur to be released in the form of hydrogen sulfide. The hydrogen sulfide emitted by the volcano will now be absorbed by the clouds, which then becomes rain and fall back to the soil. Stage 2 was through soil. The sulfate that dissolves in the soil is taken up the roots. The sulfur compounds are now used for photosynthesis. Animals also obtain the sulfur they need by eating the plants. Stage 3 was the mineralization. When sulfur coal is burned, the sulfur combines with oxygen creates sulfur dioxide, which then combines with the molecules in the air, creating acid rain. Stage 4 was under the sea. The sulfur peptides that may have accumulated in the clouds would fall to the sea. The sulfur will evaporate back into the clouds, releasing it to the soil, and thus repeating the cycle all over. And that would be all for sulfur cycle. Watching.